it's always been maintaining a distance of 500, 600 yards. So I could probably assume that the replacement Coast Guard vessel also maintains the same distance.
Ilan ang Philippine vessels?
There's only one official public vessel or Coast Guard vessel in Skoda Shoal. That's only BRP Teresa Magbanwa.
Yung CCG na monitor na.
The CCG vessel, we have to continue counting pa. Because as I said, no, when they monitor the 44-meter vessels na papalapit, dumami na din yung humarang. So as of this time, we're still tallying the actual number of Coast Guard vessels there.
Sir, may actual cost, estimated cost na ba yung damages dun sa dalawang barko natin?
Wala pa, because ngayon, ang Philippine Coast Guard vessel, despite of their structural damage, still decided to carry on with their mission in providing supplies sa ating mga tropa sa Patag Island and Lawak Island. Yes, they didn't go back. They're still completing their mission as we speak.
So do you think after this collision incident, China will still insist on BRP Teresa being removed? And will the Philippines file another diplomatic protest?
On the part of the Philippine Coast Guard, we're just here to document the unlawful actions, the illegal presence of the Chinese Coast Guard and the Chinese Maritime Militia. With regard to the decision of the filing of the diplomatic protest, I think it's up to the Department of Foreign Affairs.
Sir, may relevance ba na gabi ginawa yung madaling araw? Ginawa sa pagmadaling?
I don't think so. Nagkataon lang, as I said, Chino, no? Ang 44-meter vessels natin, madaling araw lang talaga dumaan sa Skoda Shoal. However, the intention of these 44-meter vessels is not to be deployed in Skoda Shoal. Dumaan lang siya, proceeding to Patag Island and Lawak Island.
Sir, ba't hindi na lang po lansya yung nag-resupply?
Hindi tayo nagdadala ng lansya sa pag-resupply natin sa ating mga occupied areas. The only chartered vessel that is being used is for BRP Sierra Madre in Ayungan Shoal. But as far as the Coast Guard is concerned, especially on those Coast Guard deployed personnel na different maritime features, ang ginagamit natin mula noon hanggang ngayon are Coast Guard vessels.
Sir, just for background, gano'n na sir katagal yung Magbanwa naka-deploy? And since its deployment, are there any recent observation out of ordinary observations? Because you're there to document, diba sir, yung supposed small time, small scale reclamation. Meron ba sir pagbabago, may mga bagong nakita based on your presence?
Tarriela Magbanwa has been in Skoda Shoal since April 16. So in total, 125 days na siya. If you're going to ask me, are there observations that we notice? I think most of the significant observation that we had were released to the media, like they did naval exercises and PBS operation, the presence of the marine scientific research, all those kind of stuff.
Are they building an artificial island?
As far as the Coast Guard is concerned, the mere fact that the Philippine Coast Guard maintains our presence there, as I said a few months ago, the size of the suspected area that is being reclaimed remains to be the same. This means that we remain to be successful in preventing the small-scale reclamation from being completed.
Sir, walang pagbabago since then or even additional deployment by Chinese vessels?
None. There. It depends. There are instances that Chinese maritime militia are increasing. There are also instances that it's only a China Coast Guard vessel. So there's not so much significance regarding deployment. As of this time, based on our recent interaction with the commanding officer of the vessels, there are no Coast Guard personnel who were injured as a result of the collision done by the Chinese Coast Guard.
Sir, is the ship still seaworthy? Mukhang malaki yung hole.
I still don't know. It's still going to be evaluated by naval architects, people with the right background to evaluate the seaworthiness of the vessel. But as I said, despite of these damages, the commanding officer of 4410 and 4411 still decided to pursue their resupply mission.
So
As I recall, sir, this is the biggest damage on a Philippine Coast Guard ship, no, ever since last year.
Yes, we can fairly say that this is the biggest damage, structural damage that we have incurred as a result of the dangerous maneuver carried out by the Chinese Coast Guard, which resulted to collision. Yes, that's why they are the commanding officer is taking extra caution as they proceed to Patag and Lawak Island.
Hanggang saan sumunod, sir, yung mga barko ng CCG, sir?
Well, gaya ng sinabi ko kanina, no, the moment na na-realize nila na ang Coast Guard vessels will not be proceeding directly to Skoda as their final destination, eventually bumitaw na rin naman sila. However, they still shadowed, but not so much of dangerous maneuver. No, this is kumbaga the gravest na damage na na-incur natin.
Okay, sir, but in the press con, Jim asked you if this was the first violent incident recorded during a resupply to Lawak and Pranaga. Sabi mo, sir, una nga siyang
best. Yes.
Right. But sir, kasi we regularly send resupply there.
Saan daw camera? Ang dami kasing camera. Meron dito, meron doon. Ano?
Regular naman, sir, na resupply there is regular. Before, have we had any encounters? You said this is the gravest, but in terms of...
Yes, this is also the first time that the Chinese Coast Guard subjected Philippine Coast Guard vessels with this kind of dangerous maneuver resulting to collision. In the past, we have been doing the resupply operation, the routine resupply operation of the Philippine Coast Guard personnel in different Chinese maritime features, but we never had experienced this kind of collision. Well, una sa lahat, hindi ito critical dahil sa position natin. Ang sinasabi ko lang kanina is that sa Skoda Shoal, sa mga nakaraang linggo, sa mga nakaraang araw na nagko-complain ng China, kinukomplain nila na ang Coast Guard vessel daw has been staying there for a long time already. Gaya ang sinabi ko, Tarriela Magbanwa has been there since April 16. Ang critical lang dito sa usapan natin is that when they monitored the 4410 and 4411 passing through the vicinity of Skoda Shoal, it was subjected to a dangerous maneuver that resulted to collision. Ang implication nito is that siguro iniisip nila na itong mga 44-meter vessels na to will be reinforcing the presence of Tarriela Magbanwa, which is their paranoia, no, thinking na ito nga ay talagang it serves their own lies and belief, no? Now, we're just there to reinforce 9701. That's the reason why we are thinking, no, na ito ang dahilan kung bakit nila hinarang talaga at nagresulta ng banggaan.